We're without Karen. And that's unprecedented, you know, because she's always loved Christmas Eve at home with the family.
Has she?
In fact, a few Christmases ago, she did a lovely deed, which I'd like to tell you about, because I don't want you to think badly of it, you know. Several Yuletides passed, and the TV news broadcasts were scenes of starving Africans, most shocking. Karen, then aged 10, decided there and then to forego the satsuma in her Christmas stocking. She popped it in the post. Instructions were enclosed for the proper distribution of this sundry. Make sure my tangerine is shared fairly between the little boys and girls who are so hungry. Karen's tangerine, the gesture of the queen. How generous she's been. Oh, Karen's tangerine. I think Karen's plan was that each village should receive a segment, you know. Christmas came and went, no thank you note was sent to say the gift was gratefully accepted. Did Karen's mission fail? Did it perish in the mail? Or was it somehow cruelly intercepted? You know, an unscrupulous army captain might have seized it at gunpoint and gobbled it all up himself without even giving any to his men. We just don't know, do you? Anyway, I think it was a fantastic gesture on my daughter's part. Oh, Karen's tangerine, the gesture of a queen. How generous she's been. Oh, Karen's tangerine. Yeah, definitely. Karen's tangerine. Contrasts very sharply with the current behaviour, you know. Yeah. Mary, why have you got your coat on?
Right.
You cold?